This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Need a domain or website? You can make it with Squarespace. Okay, I'm about to commit film snob heresy by saying this, but I'm gonna be honest. I've never liked silent films. Yep, I know, Chaplin, Keaton, and Lloyd are movie legends, and I know you have no business calling yourself a student of film unless you're willing to kiss the tramp's ring, but I just didn't get it, alright? Way too many repeated gags, surface-level slapstick storytelling, long stretches where nothing really remarkable happens, and wildly varying runtimes made it really hard for me to ever get into them. It's not that I didn't have a healthy respect for the classics, I did, I just, you know, didn't think they aged well in today's modern filmmaking landscape. I'm fully aware that at the time they were developed, the silent film classics were technical marvels and created the foundation for the entire industry that we enjoy today. As a practitioner of film, I studied and dissected City Lights, Metropolis, and The General. These films helped me understand the medium and become better at the craft. But nary was there airy a lazy Friday evening when I sat down in the living room with a tub of popcorn and said to myself, you know what I'm in the mood to watch? Le Voyage dans la Lune. There's a sci-fi flick that'll get my heart pumping. Point is, I watched them academically, never recreationally. But ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I want you to know that after this month, I have both literally and figuratively changed my tune. Because it turns out, it wasn't that I didn't enjoy silent films, I was just watching them wrong. We live in an era of home movie entertainment, but in the mid-1890s to the late 1920s, motion pictures were a purely theatrical experience. Film started off with no synchronized sound. This meant no pre-recorded music, no audible dialogue, no THX logo coming at you like, no big flashy, just the moving pictures. But that by itself is mad boring and totes my goats awkward to sit through in a crowded auditorium, so in order to pump some romp and circumstance into the flicks, theater runners had to do it all practically. While the movie was being displayed on the projector, a pianist would sit off to the side and play the movie's soundtrack live. See, back then, distributors, they would send the film reels to theaters packaged with the accompanying sheet music for an in-house musician or musicians to play. Large enough venues, they might even employ a small orchestra so that the theater-goers could enjoy the movie's music to its fullest extent. Ironically, so-called silent movies were all about music. People would travel far and wide to attend screenings with the largest accompaniments. In many places, going to the movies meant going to a concert. Charlie Chaplin's flicks were never meant to be watched alone on the couch, in the dark, in your living room. These movies were meant to be watched in front of a live orchestra in a crowded theater full of energetic patrons willing to have a good time. Considering this made me, at the very least, entertain the idea that I hadn't been giving silent films a fair shake. Maybe if I could somehow watch these old reels in the original setting in which they were screened, I would look at this whole thing differently. But let's be real, how could I ever hope to recreate an experience like that today? Well, wouldn't you know it, there are people out there right now trying to make a living by doing just that. Springfield, Missouri is home to the Galois Theater, a historic site built in 1926 on the newly announced Route 66. It was originally a hybrid theater that hosted both vaudeville and film presentations. It eventually closed, but was restored and reopened in 2006, and it's played host to all kinds of concerts and events in town ever since. Earlier this month, I went there with a few friends to see, or rather hear, the Peacherine Ragtime Society Orchestra. They're a group of musicians that travel across the United States recreating the syncopated stylings of ragtime, theater, and dance music. And their show, Masters of Silent Comedy, underscores classic silent films with an authentic recreation of the movie-going experience. During the show, a small theater orchestra plays along to three well-known silent films, Buster Keaton's One Week, Laurel and Hardy's Big Business, and Charlie Chaplin's The Adventurer, in a manner such as you would experience during the movie's original screenings. During the show, they play off of authentic, original sheet music for the films, and many authentic, original period instruments. The Ragtime Society made these silent films of yesteryear come alive in a way I didn't think was possible. This mix of live performance and film projection, it's something I haven't experienced before, and it added a completely new dimension to these works that so many, including myself, have written off from time to time as antiquated and even boring. I genuinely enjoyed watching these movies as the musicians played accompaniment to the images, giving them emotional depth. I was on the edge of my seat as the drummer juggled seemingly dozens of different instruments to generate the movie's sound effects in real time. There's really nothing quite like this. Watching silent films in this context made me not only appreciate, but actually enjoy the medium's peculiarities. Without dialogue, silent movies rely on visual communication through facial expression, body language, and the occasional on-screen graphic. This isn't new information to you, I'm sure, but it cannot be stated enough just how easier said than done this actually is. It's hard for me as a filmmaker to convey stories without spoken words. I would not have worked well in a time period without them. To tell stories before the invention of talkies meant mastering the art of minimalism. How do you convey exposition and dialogue with as few cutaways as possible? Leaning upon text as a crutch via a constant barrage of title cards would be dull and tedious for an audience to sit through, so often a silent film's on-screen conversations are distilled to only the heaviest punchlines or the most profound thoughts. Most of all, the live orchestral element made the theatrical experience thrilling again. See, when you're attending a live concert, there's an element of suspense to everything. Will the musicians hit their cues? Will they flub a sequence? Will the various sections of the orchestra harmonize correctly? What if an instrument breaks or something technical falls apart? It's a high-wire act the whole way through, and the audience is along for the ride. In a strange way, having the musicians in-house, occasionally improvising here or there, with the crowd reacting to every tonal decision they made, felt way more exciting to me than watching a blockbuster flick filled with highly perfected and precisely edited sound and images. Stories told in this medium, in this way, they don't need modern technical innovations to entertain. So I'm not ashamed to admit that I've been wrong about silent films. Watching these movies at home during my film study days felt like a chore. Sitting in a beautiful theater and watching them like this felt fun. And after all, isn't that the point of the majority of this era's films? Bring people together, give them a few laughs, and maybe make a dreary evening a little brighter. Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Do you have an idea for a creative project, maybe a personal blog or even a small business? Then chances are you're going to need a website to get it off the ground. You're in luck. For the past 15 years, Squarespace has been making it easy to design and operate websites of all shapes and sizes. They've got beautiful designer templates, the ability to manage an online storefront, and 24/7 customer support to answer any questions you may have. There's no better time to get started making your idea a reality, and I've got a special offer to make it even easier. Go to squarespace.com to start your free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/AustinMcConnell to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.